Hello everyone, my name is Nicky Kirschmann, Global PLM for the Optical Handhelds and Test Tools. Today we're going to talk about the new firmware for our Smart Pocket V2 variant. This is 3.01 for our broadband tools, the OP35 V2, the OP35 SC and the OP38 V2. We have the 3.01 for our selective pump power meter, the OP37X V2, and we do have a new firmware for our TruePON testers, which is 3.02. And this is for OP39G and X. In this video, I will focus on the broadband variants because there we have the biggest improvements for optical loss tests. So I'm going to show you the screen of the OP35 V2 and doing some tests. The new firmware includes bug fixes, but is primarily focused on the behavior and the user experience for the optical loss features. So if you want to do optical loss testing on either OP37X V2 or OP39, the same rules apply with the same hints. And if you do have any further questions after you watch this video, please feel free to reach out to the people and myself. So let's get deeper into the measurement. I have an OP35 V2 connected via USB to my laptop, so I can use Smart Reporter to share the screen of the OP35 V2, and I do use an OLS36 V2 as a light source. Here we are in the OptiCheck mode, that means the user does not need to select anything. We'll basically see an optical power shown on the screen in the single mode range, and if I change the measurement mode on the OP35 V2 by pressing the mode key at the bottom, we get to the broadband or expert mode where we have more possibilities to change the settings. On the left soft key, we see the wavelength, and if we press the left soft key shorter than a second or very quickly, you see that the wavelength changes. And if I press it again, I can toggle between several wavelengths, 6 in total, and there's also a second frame behind the first frame, that means there's a second function. So if I press longer than a second, I can change the wavelength to a specific wavelength that I want to. So instead of 50-50 nanometer, I can choose to have 50-49. And we do offer calibrated wavelengths for the Smart Pocket V2s. But if a user wants to have a different wavelength, we still provide accurate measurements because we interpolate between those calibrated wavelengths. In the middle soft key, you see the abstref. I'll talk about that later because this is the important point. And on the right soft key, you see at the moment the unit set to power in dBm. And again, there's a second frame behind the first one. That means if we press longer than a second, what will happen is that it will change from dBm to watt. So in this case, it changed to 467 microwatt. If I press the right soft key again longer than a second, it will change back to dBm. It might be helpful for a couple of customers too. If we press the right soft key just a second, we change the unit. So here we went from the absolute power testing to the loss testing. You see that we still have a big bold number on the screen, but in that case we have dB because we are in the loss unit, and we also see that the reference optical power level is shown below that, marked as ref and 0.00 dBm because we haven't set a reference yet. This is the right thing. If we press the right soft key again, we change the unit to power pass fail, and you see a bold pass in the middle. Below you see the optical power level, in that case minus 3.30 dBm, and on the right side you see the optical power level limit, which is set as minus 65 dBm. So anything that is higher than minus 65 dBm will result into a pass. We can change that limit if we press the right soft key longer than a second. And you see that we can change the power limit for this wavelength to the wavelength we want to be, and we've chosen to show the extreme values because we want to avoid users to experience a fail in the very beginning, and if they accidentally got to the power pass fail or last pass fail, they won't notice the fail, and they will get familiar with themselves after they figure out how to use that. So here we've changed the limit to -64.8 dBm, and still a pass because it's the -3.3 dBm is higher than -64.8 dBm. If we press the right soft key again, we get to the lost pass fail, and here's the bold pass in the middle again. We have 3.3 dB in loss at the moment because the limit, the upper limit for the loss is set to 75 dB. And we can change that limit by pressing the right soft key longer than a second. So we can decide to have 74.9 dB, confirm that for this wavelength, and it will be shown on the screen. That is a change compared to the last firmware because it was kind of hidden in the middle soft key and the user had to consciously choose that. In that case, it remains to consciously choose the limits and the wavelengths, but it's cleaned up on the display. So let's talk a little bit about the reference, which I announced to be the major improvement compared to the previous firmware. So let's get to 1310 because this is the wavelength that I'm currently using on the light source. By pressing the left soft key, we can easily achieve that. We have -2.6 dBm. This is our broadband expert measurement mode where we see the absolute power. And what I want to do now is to set the reference. And you see that in the middle soft key, we have the abstref. And for those that are very familiar with previous firmware, will think that, okay, there's no second frame. That means I just have to press a second on the middle soft key and I'll set a new reference. So let's have a look what happens if I press just 1 second on the middle soft key. What will happen is that the user will see the information, hey, you have to press longer than a second in order to set a new reference. And why is that? We want to avoid that users accidentally set a new reference. Usually, if you're carrying out an optical loss test in the field, you set the reference once in the very beginning, and then you move with your power meter to the respective location to carry out your tests. And you really want to avoid after the 4th or 5th or 16th measurement that you accidentally set a new reference and you have to repeat your whole task. That's not desired. Okay, so we have to press longer than a second on the middle soft key to set a new reference. Let's do that now. I press the middle soft key longer than a second. And what will happen is that you see the 0.00 dB in the middle, and the reference is shown below this bold value, which is -2.6 dBm. That's good. And what you've also noticed is that on the right soft key, the unit has changed from power to loss, right? Setting a reference means we are consciously wanting to carry out an optical loss test, so we also change the unit with that. If I want to have a pass-fail on that, I can change the unit again on the right soft key by going from loss to power pass-fail to the pass-fail on the absolute power. And if I press the right soft key again, I come to the loss pass-fail unit. And you see at the moment it's a pass because 0 dB is lower than 75 dB. Again, we've discussed about how to change the limit by pressing the right soft key longer than a second. So let's say -74.8 dB, confirming that, and it will be shown on the screen. It's still a pass, even if I would pull out the connector a little bit. Again, I'm just explaining how it works. Of course, I would move with the OP to a test location. So I pulled the connector out a little bit from the UPP port, and I have 1.32 dB which is my loss. So we can decide to save it now and carry on with our testing. I will also want to highlight a couple of things that are different compared to the last firmware when we use auto lambda functions, provided that we are using a VRV light source. In order to use the auto lambda functions, we need to make sure that auto lambda is enabled on the unit. So if I press the mode button longer than a second, I get to the settings and I navigate to auto lambda. In that case, it's on, and we want that to be. So let me get back to the measurement mode. What I'm doing now is getting back to the absolute power, connecting the connector back fully. And what I'm going to do now is I change my mode on the light source from single lambda to auto lambda. And what will happen is that the left soft key shows auto lambda, so I cannot press the left soft key anymore. Well, I can press it, but nothing will happen. And instead of the CV or the tone, I see the 1310 nanometer as the wavelength that is automatically detected. And the optical power changes too, because we are modulating the signal. So if I'm about to change the wavelength on my source to 50-50, the power meter will recognize that and show 50-50 on the screen. And again, we can continue to do our loss testing, the power, the pass-fail units if we want to, and it will behave the exact same. So our VRV light sources, most of them have the multi-lambda feature. That means I can change to multi-lambda, and what will happen is that one wavelength at a time is sent, and the OP has the function to translate that into the respective optical power. So let me change to multi-lambda, and what you see is that after 1 or 2 seconds, both wavelengths are shown on the screen. Please keep in mind, this is not a selective PON measurement. We're still using a broadband tool. This is just a way that we can benefit from using a kit of a source and an optical power meter of our portfolio. And you see that 1310 is shown as minus 5.62 dBm and 5050 nanometer is shown at minus 5.67 dBm. We can continue to do the loss testing, the power, and so on. We can set the reference for both wavelengths, and again, pressing just a second will result into this notification. I'll show that again. Hey, you have to press longer than a second to set a new reference. So let's do that. We press longer than a second, and what will happen is that the reference is shown under the wavelength. So for 1310, we have the reference at minus 5.62 dBm, and respectively for 5050. And if I'm about to pull the connector out from the UPP port of the OP35V2, you will see that we get the dB values on the screen, 1 dB, 1.17 dB. Again, being able to continue to do the pass-fail things. In this case, you see that there's no second frame anymore behind the power pass-fail frame or the right soft key. And if I am about to press the power pass-fail longer than a second, there's no function behind it. So how do I change the limit for the respective wavelength? I would need to get back to the single wavelength mode. Either switch the light source off, or what would be better is to pull out the connector. But please make sure that you make the people aware that they shouldn't stare into the connector to avoid eye damage. What we can do now is using the second function of the power pass fail or loss pass fail, set the limit to the value we want to, and get back to our multi-lambda measurement by connecting to the OP35V2 again. It takes a couple of seconds, and then we see both wavelengths. We also have sources with 3 or 4 wavelengths. The Smart Pocket V2 power meters can handle up to 3 wavelengths, and you'll also see the values below the wavelength for 1310, the reference, the limit, 5050 for 4090 respectively. So again, these are the major updates to the optical loss testing, and I've mentioned that it's you have to get used to finding the right settings to in order to have the right configuration before carrying out the test. It's much easier using VRVTPA because all the configuration is sent from StrataSync via mobile tech app to the instrument, and the only thing the user have to do, remember to set the reference at the first location, then moving to the test locations to carry out the tests. That was it for today. I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. If you do have any further questions, please reach out to the original PLMs, the ASCs, and myself. Thank you very much.